Everybody's waking up. There's a nice little Shasta, about a 50-something, 53 maybe, 52 early Shasta. Nice. Mine's going to be painted similarly. It's going to have that yellow and I'm going to paint the top white. It just won't have the Z. It'll have its own markings, the wings.
Yep, that's pretty much it. You just keep taking the fuel in. I've already been through a couple water bottles worth of electrolyte powder and water. Let's see. An energy gel.
Somebody is running one of the trails at about three-quarters his capability and talking on the ham radio. He's got a little handheld with him and he's talking over the Keller Peak repeater. I'm up in Wrightwood at the top of Mountain High, just going down to town to get a few things. And Tabby's with me. Oh, Tabby. So we just spent the night up here. It was really nice. Got out of the heat. Left yesterday, Friday. And we're going to playing with a ham radio here, too, listening in. So we're going to go down and get some stuff to eat, or, you know, just some little, few supplies. Need some extra things, ice and stuff. So.
I did hear him earlier, though. So hopefully he can hear us, but that's definitely him. He's just having a rough time making it to the repeater right now. K60DK, over to you, VH.
A beer gun in there, buddy. And, but yeah, these long runs, I've got a friend of mine who, just for fun, runs marathons. Not through rough terrain, but out on paved streets, and she trains for it, and it's just like a good mechanism for her.
Yeah, I get the repeater good up here. Kind of a nice view from up here. Not really sure what I'm looking at, to be honest with you. I don't know what valley that is, or what that is. I know there's a fire in the Tehachapi, so you can see some smoke streaks in the air. I really don't know what we're looking at, to be honest with you. I'll have to look it up on Google Earth when I get home. I think we're looking north here. Up here, backside of Mountain High. So, there's no, I'm down below the ski runs now. I think that's, I don't know, some cleared areas up there. Some towers up there. Oh, look, here's an old, some kind of a, this, oh, this must be part of a, I don't know what that is. Part of an old winch or something? Yeah, I'm not real sure what that is. Unless it's some kind of, you know, maybe something somebody used to practice a jump or something here. I don't know. But yeah, it's a winch. It's an old winch. It's probably a motor mounted here. There is a lot of crushed rock here. This might have been part of a mine at one time. Yeah, could have been. Taking a little stop here, looking at the view. There's that marine layer and keeping us cool this summer. It's been absolutely amazing. We've had the coolest summer that I ever remember out here in this part of the state. It's really nice up here. I bet it's about, 75, 4, something like that. So. And we're just out cruising around. I went past the turnoff for the camp, wanted to just kind of see where the road went. So that's what we're doing. Tabby wanted to get out and sniff the flowers, didn't you? Yeah. Make sure you share with those bees. There's bees. The bees are running around doing their thing. Don't want to bother them. Tabby, don't get bit. So, yeah, this is a really good place to just get away for the weekend. It's only a little over an hour away from where I live, and I'm up hanging around 7,000 feet, you know, average. It's probably pretty warm and humid down there because you got the marine layer, and the temperature was coming up. Even though we have high pressure, we have a marine layer. It's weird. I don't understand that at all. Anyway, it's a beautiful, beautiful day. Tabby's sitting in the shade. She's found herself a good little place there to hang out. And yeah, I'm just enjoying the view. And yeah. Love it up here. Glad I'm not down there. Got your little place in the shade there, don't you? Tabby? Now, this is interesting. I just noticed this nailed to the side of the tree with some little plastic and wire plants, I guess. You know. It's up there. About 9 feet. And this is a weird looking tree. Kind of reminds me of the bristlecone trees. You know, the way it's all curly and twisted. And I don't know if that happens from fires or what. You can see how it's all curly and twisty. Doesn't it look like a bristlecone? But it's right here overlooking this big canyon. Wrightwood is over there to my left on the other side of that mountain there. So, that's weird. I wonder what some kind of a memorial or something. Maybe somebody died around here somewhere. Who knows? Weird. I'm thinking we ought to go back, but I hate to disturb Tabby. She's so comfortable looking.